Hey filmmaker, Chung Dha here. In this video, I'm going to show you how to get this glitch effect in Premiere Pro. So it's a pretty nice effect to use for your logo or intro or actually title text, especially if you are doing like a event video with a lot of like party theme stuff. This is a quite interesting way to show a title instead of just using a simple fade in. So first things first, in the description below there will be a link to the presets. There is a social locker on it, so either subscribe, like my page, Google+, tweet or share this post, or follow me on Twitter, and any of these buttons will just unlock the download link, and then you can download the presets. So no payment needed. If you are really support me, you can go to this button below and donate any amount if you really appreciate I'm doing this, and so I can also continue doing more. So let's go back to Premiere. So here we don't have it anymore in here. So what you have to do is go to the preset bin, right click, and then import preset. We got it in the desktop here. Okay, pretty much we are set right now. I'm going to make a new sequence to start from nothing, and then we have the logo that we want to use, and I want it to be at least have like some black or empty space before the actual logo come in. And I want the logo actually to be much smaller. This is pretty big. So this is on the nice side. I want it, the effect, to last only 10 frames. I'm holding shift and then arrow key to jump 5 frames instead of manually. So twice is then it jumps 10 frames. So we cut it here because we just want it to be a glitch in the start and stop, and then show the actual logo. So first things first, we are going to nest this logo and then call it logo nested size. So the reason why I'm going to nest it is because I'm going to add the split RGB effect on this, and if I'm going to throw in the RGB effect, it will mess with the size because I already changed the size of the logo, but the effect on its own have also a motion for the size, so it will mess with each other if I don't nest it. So first we're going to drop in these effects, so get it a nice RGB split, and then these three we select and also nest and call this RGB split. And from here we are going to copy this. Inside here we have a black video. To make that is just right mouse click or here below new item and choose a black video. You can also use color matte, but for this one we only need a black video. So here we're going to put the black video, and actually I'm going to move it up. So this is going to be layer 4, and we are going to put the glitch matte pattern. So this will automate a glitch effect. But yeah, we are, it's fully automated and it actually goes on for 10 seconds. So if you want to use it for something else, it's also quite a nice effect. And we're going to put the mat key. So mat key 1 and mat key 2. So now we already have the glitch effect here. And the reason why I'm actually, there's empty space between here is we are going to put a adjustment layer between here for an extra effect. You can put it in there between it, or you can put it later, but it's slightly better to put it between there. Let's first make adjustment layer, so it's just here, and make an adjustment layer. I already have one here, so the adjustment layer goes between there, and we are going to add glitch noise on the adjustment layer. So if you can see, it will have like an extreme noise. Either way, you can like maybe make it just that only a few frames of it has that extreme noise. But I found another nice look for it is to go into here, and we are going to make a mask. So, and just draw like a pretty big triangle. So it's only like partial of the logo where there's a noise instead of the entire logo. The reason why it has to be like this is so that this effect doesn't actually go into the layer below it, or into the background layer, because when all this is done, we are also going to select all those and nest it. That will be the glitch effect. So now it's pretty much done. And one effect extra you can also add is the light flash. So they will give it a quick exposure difference. And yeah, make it flash a little bit. And pretty much you can like copy out and like make a small, just take a small chunk and put it down a little bit later, so it also glitches between it a few times. And yeah, pretty much that is it. And yeah, nesting it all, it just keeps it quite nice. And also because it's the noise is actually nested, it won't affect what's under here. Is this? So it doesn't like, because the triangle is drawn pretty big here, it doesn't affect anything below here. So you can just have anything, any video on the background, and yeah, that one effect won't be affected. And also now it's pretty nice. It's just like a small video with it being all nested. It's actually quite nicer to work on a timeline like this instead of I've shown here with like a lot of things, or actually it's still the same, but yeah, if you actually go into, you have like so many extra layers, so it's quite nicer to have it just being a single layer instead of having so many layers on top of each other. So that was mainly it. If you like this video, please give me a thumbs up. If you want to see more upcoming videos, please subscribe. If you have any questions or you want to see any other tutorials or presets being made, please comment below, and I'll hope to see you the next time. Bye bye.